Good morning, guys. Captain Dylan Hubbard here at Hubbard's Marina with another gorgeous morning inside Johns Pass. Little cloudy to start the day, but gorgeous nonetheless. And the weather is just gonna be epically perfect the next couple of days. We've got dolphins playing this morning. We've got tons of bait in the pass causing all this bird action. It is just picturesque inside Johns Pass. And the weather, as far as the eye can see, for the next 7 to 9 days, I mean, 1 foot or less near shore. And then offshore, it's looking like 2 foot or less. I mean, just crystal clear, flat, calm conditions for the next foreseeable future. So great time to get out there and enjoy some time on the water, some fun in the sun. And don't forget about our Fox 13 thing this morning. On Fox 13's Good Day Tampa Bay with Russell Rhodes, I'm going to be talking live on camera with Russell, doing a fishing report and giving you guys lots of information about inshore and near shore and offshore fishing. So tune in this morning to Fox 13 on obviously channel 13 for you locals. If you're not local, you can look up Fox 13 News on Google and go to their website. You can watch live on their website page. So if you can't tune into Fox 13 to watch that live report around 8:30, 8:40 a.m. this morning, you can always watch it live on their website. Also, don't forget about our live stream show this Sunday night if you want to win some free fishing trips. We've got our Bass Pro Shops event coming up May 18th, Saturday, May 18th, if you want to join us at Bass Pro. And then as far as what's going on right now, guys, we're catching tons of fish. The fishing is going very well near shore. We're seeing lots of fishing action with hogfish. The hogfish bite's actually been picking up quite a bit this past week. We had a hub 5-hour half day that did very well on the hog fishing twice this week. So really cool to see the hogfish bite pick up a little bit. Overall, the hogfish have been a little tough the last couple weeks. We haven't really been seeing many of them on our party boat trips, the 10 hour all day, the 5-hour half day. Hasn't really been seeing a ton of those hogfish. But this week, the private charter got some really nice hogfish 2 days in a row. Yesterday, the 5-hour half day had some nice hogfish come off of it. So it seems like the hogfish bite has picked up a little bit for us, and we're hoping that trend continues. The mackerel, same thing. The mackerel bite's been a little bit tough. The water's been really murky because of those rapid cold fronts, but the water seems to have cleared up a little bit near shore. And with this gorgeous week of weather ahead, it seems like those mackerel should come back for us more and more. Yesterday's half day probably picked up close to a half dozen mackerel while trolling, and hopefully that trend continues again through this beautiful upcoming week and this great weather we're having. And then also near shore, we're seeing some of those lane snapper out there in the deeper near shore waters. The red grouper bite's picking up again near shore, which is good to see, being as though it was pretty much non-existent in the first part of this year because of that deep water spawn. But those red groupers seem to be picking up a little bit for us in the deepest near shore waters. Offshore, we're seeing really good action on scamp grouper, red grouper, and then we're seeing a lot of big triggerfish mixed in and a few nice big mangroves mixed in as well, anywhere from about 170 to about 200 foot of water. So really, really good fishing near shore and offshore. You can also find those red grouper offshore anywhere from about 110 to about 140 foot of water. We're seeing some yellowtail snapper right in the middle there, around 140, 160. And overall, the bite is going very well. The pelagic action offshore has been a little slow for us this week, but there's a lot of big kingfish, anywhere from about 130 to about 170. And the blackfin tuna, anywhere past 100 foot of water, you have a great shot at catching some blackfin tuna, but it just didn't pan out for us this week. This weekend, we have a super light 39-hour trip Only 22 people heading out this afternoon at 3 o'clock on our 39-hour trip. So they should have a great weekend of fishing, plenty of opportunities to flatline and troll. So this weekend's 39-hour, I'm hoping, brings back a pile of pelagic fish and snapper and grouper too. So super light loads right now. Our half-day trips, our 10-hour trips, our private charters, everything's running light, guys. So a great opportunity to get out here, enjoy this gorgeous, perfect weather condition this week, and enjoy the flat or the lower numbers of people on the boat, because come June 1st, come July, it's going to be busy around here, guys. So this is your week. 2 weeks to take advantage of it. Once the kid starts coming out of school, it's gonna get crazy on the beaches, guys. So take advantage of this great weather, great fishing, and get out in the water, because remember, if you're too busy to go fishing, you're just too darn busy. We hope to see you for our live stream show starting Sunday night, 8:30 p.m. And we hope that you can join us for our Fox 13 thing this morning. Again, that Fox 13 event is gonna be at 8:30 to 8:40 a.m. We're gonna be live with Russell Rhodes and the Good Day Tampa Bay crew, talking inshore, nearshore, and offshore fishing. That will be a little bit more inshore and nearshore focused, but we're gonna sprinkle in some offshore fishing there too if we got time. And hopefully everybody will enjoy it. Hopefully Fox 13 will get a lot of good feedback, and we'll be able to have longer and longer segments over time. This morning we're only going to have about 3 minutes. This is the first one, and hopefully they'll enjoy it. I think they will, because everybody loves fishing, right? Great time to get out there on the water, guys. Hope to see you all this week. Hopefully you enjoyed this gorgeous morning view inside Johns Pass. Have a great day, y'all.